I lost my best friend, Pat Whitty, 5 years ago today. I still miss him. People in Tigray are losing whole families these past few months because of the war crimes of Ethiopia's unelected Prime Minister, Abiy Ahmed. And the government is doing all it can to hide the truth. Ethiopian Ambassador to EU, Hirat Zamin, came to our Foreign Affairs Committee 2 weeks ago, and a lot of what she had to say was a work of fiction. She said, "We are restoring the law and order situation. The operation, as you might be aware," she said, "has been concluded within 3 weeks." This is not true. After 13 weeks, fighting continues. She said, "The Ethiopian government is focused on delivering much anticipated humanitarian assistance." Not true. The Ethiopian government has done everything in its power to prevent humanitarian aid reaching the people of Tigray. Aid agencies have been badly frustrated. She said, "The Abiy Ahmed government tried its best to take on board the TPLF leadership." Not true. As soon as Abiy became Prime Minister, he set out to isolate the TPLF and the people of Tigray. He dissolved the ruling coalition of which TPLF were part of. Now he's expelled 17,000 Tigray soldiers from the Ethiopian army, and Ethiopian's airline have fired all their workers from Tigray. If Abiy's government had any interest in the truth, it would allow independent UN-led investigations in Tigray and give access to independent media. In total violation of international law, Eritrean troops are in Tigray committing unspeakable atrocities, murdering civilians, looting, destroying public property, factories, hospitals and religious sites. And still Abiy Ahmed denies the presence of Eritrean troops in Tigray. His peace deal with Isaias Afwerki, Eritrea's president, looks more like a war deal now, a vengeful marriage of convenience against the people of Tigray. A government accused of committing war crimes in Tigray, using hunger as a weapon, and one that continues to blatantly lie about the involvement of Eritrean troops in Tigray, cannot be trusted to deliver relief to Tigray. A government that deliberately burned fields of crops in Tigray cannot be trusted with delivering food aid. A government that causes suffering and deaths on its own citizens in a treacherous partnership with Eritrea's president, a ruthless dictator, cannot be trusted with ending the suffering of Tigray. Sadly, too many of the world's powers are content to ignore the slaughter taking place in Tigray. The Americans, the Russians, Saudi, UAE and others are still happy to do deals with this war criminal, Abiy Ahmed, as they scheme to plunder Ethiopia with his help. If Europe stands for anything, let's see some real effort and put an end to the persecution of the people of Tigray. And let's see Abiy Ahmed and Afwerki held to account in the International Criminal Court. Our silence is causing the deaths of hundreds of thousands.